I have a lot of heart and a lot of seed, as I've mentioned earlier.
I don't like that.
For plums?
Yes, for plums. Let's okay. see what this says. You trip and fall.
Welcome, ladies and gentlemen and non-binary friends, to a very special Bored AF. We are calling Bored AF Legacy! Woo! Please clap.
Great.
If you're not familiar with a legacy game, it is a board game that builds on itself every time you play it. If your character died in the last round, maybe their descendant comes back in the next one. If something happened in a specific room, maybe that'll affect it this next time you play. And we're gonna be playing a full-on campaign of my favorite game, Betrayal at House on the Hill. Oh, it's gonna be a grand old time, and we are coming at y'all with characters. So saddle up, Becky May, and get ready to ride on down to Funtown. But first, would you mind, you know, liking and subscribing and hitting the notification bell? Because there's gonna be a lot of these.
Do that.
It's gonna be a grand old time.
Do it.
Basically, we are a group of villagers that have noticed something weird going on with this house on top of the hill, and we've taken it upon ourselves to form a search party and get to the bottom of things. What's with the weird vibes with the house? So we're gonna be starting out outside together. We all have these different traits. If you got 4 speed, you move 4 spaces. And we're gonna one by one be revealing these different rooms. As you open a door, you add a new tile. You do whatever the tile says, you might find an item, an event might happen. But these characters are gonna work together as best they can to try to figure out what's going on. This game is played in 3 different levels. We have the ground floor, we have outside, which is part of the ground floor, we have a basement landing, and then we have an upper landing. You can see stairs here, so we're gonna have to explore this big old house, fancy house, together. Later in the game, in other rounds, there will be things called haunts, where one of us will be revealed to be a traitor, but this first time, we're just a team. So let's get it going. Left to right, I'd love to meet all of you.
Hello, everyone. I'm Douglas Whitmore of Whitmore Prunes. I've been told I'm the strongest seed of my family.
Right.
I enjoy walking, I enjoy dogs, and most other mammals.
Amazing. Who are you, my friend?
Hi. Sorry, I was waiting to be introduced, but I guess I have to do it for myself. Hello. My name is Belinda Poppy. My family owns planes, and my son is lost. I'm looking for my son. Have you seen him? No? Fine. Oh, God.
Hello, everyone. My name is Charlemagne Boodles. I'm the most educated man in the village. It being 1666, I went to 2 whole months of college. They've taught us a little bit about the Bible, cutting hair, pulling teeth, and lawn care. That is college in 1666.
Cornelius Braun, I learned in a different way, by going out into the depths of darkness, swimming through swamps with serpents, tackling a moose by its own antlers. My lineage has all been killed by beasts. I intend to die in the same fashion. To have nature itself grasp me in with its fangs and bleed out in the frickin' forest.
Right, hello. My name is Rory O'Brien, and my family's never been killed by beasts. Thank God of Christ. But we own the port ships, and we control who comes in and out of the port. And my best friend's my mum, and she warns me that there's ghosts around every corner. And I saw one in the graveyard, and I said, what are you doing here? And she never responded, because she's a ghost.
So we will all be starting with our character colors. Easy to remember because we have them here. On the front steps of this house. And the cool thing about legacy games is they come with pre-shuffled decks. You don't shuffle them. So they're going to walk us through this game, and you can only play it once. Shout out to Spencer for finding an unopened box on eBay.
Well done, Spencer.
The prologue begins. In the remote countryside of the New World, the homestead sits atop a hill. The family that lived here died of a pox. Father, mother, son, daughter, though the girl's body was never found. Carried off by wolves, there you go, some
yes,
say.
Yeah.
There are also stories about the family finding a chalice while building the house. a chalice sounds valuable. Maybe there are treasures here still. You're not the only one with this idea. Other families have come exploring as well. You all claim you've come to honor the dead, but as you crowd together upstairs, other wary glances make it plain, no one is fooled. All players place their figures on the upper landing. Whoever's reading this first, well, take the first turn. Why,
that's me.
As someone with a speed of 4 on my card, I get to move 4 different spaces. You know what? I'm going to continue exploring the upper landing. That's what treasure would be. So there's a basement card. We can't use it. This one can be upper floor. And it is the unfinished room. Ah. So I move here. Now, since I have found an item, my turn ends after I do this. I don't get to keep moving. So let's see what my item is. Mars flintlock pistol. A weapon, a firearm, a smoothbore with a short range. Play passes to my left.
Very good. I have a speed of 4 from dashing to the Amazon. My legs are strong. I will go and venture on my own. I'll go up here. I will draw one of these. Let's see, ground floor. So I can't use that, right?
Correct.
Yes, yes.
Unless you go to the ground floor.
No. Upper floor, bam. All right.
And see how Shane is connecting these yellow rooms.
Connecting it.
You'll connect the doors.
To a common room. Very good.
There is a rune in the room, but that's not something we have to deal with yet. But there is, however, an event. Bronn, this event card, would you like to read it?
Yes. Yes, I would. I can handle any event. I find a secret passage. This low wall, is it hollow here? There's something behind it. Nothing gets past Cornelius Bronn. Now, I place the secret passage sticker on this tile, then check a box below. Be careful not to cover over any symbols or runestones, of course. If there is another discovered secret passage, you may use the secret passage immediately. If you have no moves left, and the last box is checked, destroy this card.
So we've placed a secret passage card there. Check one of the boxes with your pen.
Great, very good.
And then eventually we may find where that leads to. And that is the end of your turn, Bronn.
Well, it's obviously I've got to do my speed, right?
Mm-hmm.
Yes, right, okay. So I've got 4 speed, which is good.
Mm-hmm.
Okay, I'm gonna go downstairs.
Excellent.
Right.
Yes.
Okay, and let me pull a card here.
No, so you actually don't have to yet, because
right.
There's stairs here.
Sometimes I get confused in big homes. I grew up in a tiny one bedroom.
Oh, God.
1.
Rent is outrageous.
2. 3. 4.
Oh, so you're heading outside.
I'm going outside.
You wild devil.
I need to go out in the fresh air because my mum's probably out there dropping off gifts for me.
I believe it's my Great. Turn now.
Goodbye.
I've got a speed of 4 because I've got really long limbs. So I'm going to go this way. 1.
Okay, we'll find in. You know what? We're out, I believe, of upstairs floors. So we've already explored the full upstairs.
And you know what? I changed my mind. I do it all the time. I can never make my mind up. I'm going downstairs. 1, 2, 3, 4.
Oh, you didn't want to join me?
I did not want to join you at all.
Ground floor.
The hearth.
The heart. The heart of any home.
Right. I have a lot of heart and a lot of seed, as I mentioned earlier.
I don't like that.
For plums?
Yes, for plums. Let's see what this says. You trip and fall. You trip and fall face first. You look back to see a skeletal hand sticking up from the ground holding something. You may pry the item from its hand by losing 1 speed to draw the top item card.
Do you choose to do it?
I do, because my speed is still 4.
Okay.
So I'm gonna drop 1 speed and see what item I can get.
This seems like a good time to let the audience know. If any of our stats drop to the skull, we die, as long as the haunt has started. In most rounds of this game, there is what is known as the betrayal, where one of us betrays the other, and that is when you can die. Until then, you cannot, so good choice.
Claw hammer. It's a weapon. It's practical and efficient.
All right.
Ooh, that was so boring. All right, here we go. My speed is 4. I want to go to the basement.
Too much.
1. What?
Shocking.
You're too much.
1. 2.
That's just 1.
1.
Yes, and then 2.
2. Too much for you?
Which direction would you like to go?
I want to go to the left.
The left. The crawl space with the secret passage built in.
Suck that, Irishman.
I will suck anything that you want me to.
No.
I'll suck whatever.
Having a good event.
Ooh, an event. Maybe I'll meet my son. Find. Wow. My son's lost. Here we go.
You're a liar.
Fog. Fog rises, withering and searching for something. They seem almost solid, fingers reaching out from an unseen hand. If there is a fog sticker on this tile, take one die of mental damage and bury this card. Place a fog sticker on this tile and check a box below. Be careful not to cover any symbols. When you check this second box, destroy the card.
So this fog will affect anyone else who goes through this passage, but for now you are safe. Go ahead and check that box on the card. We've placed the sticker. Now it's back to me, Cornelius, the most learned man in this house. And I can tell you, I sense the presence of demons or no demons, or something in between. All right, with 4 speed, and I know that upstairs is no longer an option, I choose to make my way. Oops.
Oops.
How embarrassing.
Don't forget your bottoms.
My bottoms fell clean off.
I don't want to see that.
There's only outside tiles left, so I'm making my way outside as best I can.
Good, come join me.
I think I'll do the same. I feel at home in the outside. The inside here is too civilized.
So I will take my 4 speed. 2, 3, 4.
Following you, Charlemagne.
Oh, nice, we invented something.
Oh, yes. I love that. Can I slap?
What is that? Absolutely
yes.
Not.
I
you're so
slap.
Far away, though. You're one tile
right.
Away.
No, I'll sorry. Slap myself. So I'm going to go somewhere, right?
Yeah.
Yeah.
One of these paths, anyway.
Can I go out this way?
You can. And it reveals.
Yes.
The woods.
Oh, I love it.
Oh, my God, the woods.
I got something.
You got an event card.
Watch out, everybody. I've got an event. Feral beast. The animals have gone feral. Oh. Teeth bared, eyes glinting with madness.
I've seen this before.
Each other player on a tile with at least one ghost takes one physical damage. Then keep reading.
I've got bad news for you. There's a skull sticker right here. So someone has died in this crawl space before. So you can take one damage from either your might or your speed.
I'll take it from my might.
Then you won't find your son.
Oh.
Sorry.
That's probably.
I survive on
get
sadness.
Get my son's name out of your mouth!
Make a might roll.
You've got 4 mites. That means for anything other than speed, that's how many dice you roll. So 4 dice you will roll.
Right, that's how I like it.
Aye. 4.
4. So, 4. You fend them off. Gain 1 in a physical trait.
Yay! Yes! Would you like to be stronger or faster?
I like to be fast.
So you move your speed up 1. Yar! I'm just gonna lean into it. I'm Charlemagne.
Yar! I am not a pirate.
Okay, here we go. 4.
Struggles.
To the left, to the right, to the left, to the right, to the left.
You can only go outside now. There's only outside tiles left.
Okay.
As the most learned man, I know architecture as well. We spent 2 days on architecture.
1.
Nature calls.
2. 3.
Let's see what it is. The pond.
I know. If your family crest is on this card, gain 1 knowledge and bury this card. Otherwise, read the text below to yourself, not out loud.
That's not
Douglas
fair.
Douglas has secrets. Douglas has secrets.
Don't make that face. Douglas don't make has... that face. His lip quivers when he's reading.
Just tell me, are you going to need your family crest on there in a second?
I don't know. Hold on, let me read it again.
Yeah, I need a family crest.
Belinda.
Belinda.
I want to join the friends and be nicer to people. Here we go, here we go. I'm going to go through the secret passage. Mm-hmm. Back out to the front. Mm-hmm. Down.
2.
1, 2.
Yep.
3.
3, okay.
Nope, what? 3.
No.
2.
Yep.
Ground floor stage. Sound safe. Stage. Mm-hmm.
Are you all right?
I, Charlemagne, will now take my turn. I will go outside and pass by. Wait, you didn't get a high five before, did you?
Right, no one high fived me.
Okay, so
I high five to myself.
1, 2.
Yes!
3. All right, let's see here. Outside, the hanging tree.
Oh, that sounds dark.
And we have our first omen.
No!
And so, like I said, we can never shuffle these cards. It's going to guide us through. When the first omen is discovered, turn over this card and read it aloud. 1666.
Right.
The chalice. Turn to entry 102 in the Bleak Journal. Alex! The Bleak Journal! I need it!
Thank you.
Thank you!
Wow, they couldn't have just put in entry 1? Like, damn, dog.
Nothing in this house seems right. What would the chalice be doing here by the tree? As for that family, how is it they died of the pox when no one else even took sick? None of it makes sense. Unless someone here is consorting with dark powers. That's it, isn't it? One of us killed the family and lured the rest of us here. One of us is a witch. Already you can feel a foul spell at work, draining your sanity away. The player who found the hanging tree draws the top card of the legacy deck, the Chalice, and gives it its true name, the Chalice of Insanity. They are now carrying it. Then draw the next card from the legacy deck and read what it says on the other side to set up the haunt. The haunt has begun. I have drawn the Chalice of Insanity. Sacred, simple carved of dark wood, the cup of a carpenter. One of us is a witch, but who is it? Draw the next five cards and turn them face up. For this is for five players. 2, 3, 4, 5. Shuffle the remaining cards face down and give one to each player. Each player secretly scratches off the box below the player count. We might need some coins in here soon. Do not scratch off any other boxes. Do not reveal what you have scratched. Each player's card will reveal one of the following: normal human or witch. There's a witch among us, but we're going to find out who. Everybody, pick a card. Pick a card. And you're going to scratch off the one next to the one that says five players to reveal whether or not you've been the witch this whole time.
Nobody look over here.
I'll tell you this, this is not dormant.
I'm not
gotta
doing...
You gotta sort of do it on the table, you just gotta couple it up.
Don't look!
So, basically right now, everyone is going to lose one sanity or two sanity per turn unless you attack someone. So we either fight or we go insane. This is what the haunt is. This is a witch hunt! It's 1666! Make your choice, Cornelius.
It's 1666, that's three sixes in a row, which means Satan.
Which means jackpot, baby!
Charlemagne, I trust you and your doctor's wisdom. I yell out from the front door. I say, Charlemagne, what do you recommend I do?
Where the hell are you? Beat the hell out of someone!
Come out of the woods.
All right. I think it'd be good sport to fight an Irishman.
So no,
I will
you don't
charge out the front door.
Don't want to do that.
So now we have our first bit of combat. The way that works is Cornelius, what is your might?
My might is 3.
And your might is 4.
Mine is 4, of course.
So we're always like to punch up.
We're gonna roll 3 dice, and you're gonna roll 4 dice, right. And we're gonna split the difference.
Fight, boys, fight!
Good luck.
Fight. Fight. Ooh, a 4.
What? And I go now, right?
Yes.
Okay. Yeah.
An Whoa. 8. So Cornelius, you take...
My mom knew I would be strong.
You take 4 physical damage from either might or speed.
Well.
You never, no, Cornelius, no.
Never fight with an Irishman,
I
sir.
Take down 4 and I am...
Literally
absolutely.
Dead.
Well, you can split it. So it could be 1, 2... And then 3, 4.
Or not.
A jolly good match! Rory, bravo!
Yeah, right. I got you with one punch, but you did well.
Guess they didn't have any Irishmen in the Amazon, did they?
No.
All right.
You did it and you didn't even break a sweat.
I didn't sweat at all. My hat stayed on the whole time. Literally.
All right, now it is your turn. Do you wish to hide away and let your sanity potentially drain away, or do you wish to finish what Cornelius started? You could fight me, you could fight
Douglas.
I'd actually really like to fight Douglas because I want to wipe that face off his face.
1, 2, so these two are going to battle. You roll your 4 might, you roll your 4 might.
3, 2, 1.
On my mother's soul.
So we have a 5 versus Christ, a 7. You take 2 physical damage from either.
Never fight in the Gaelics!
Rory! A Celtic demon!
I win it again!
And guess who's on my tile?
Oh, with the hammer!
Give me that die.
What?
Give me a die.
Well, how many do you roll now? You're still 3!
Are you still alive?
Oh, who knew prunes had so much strength?
You've got this!
Ready?
He's basically dead, you ready?
Cornelius loves Rory!
3.
On my mother's soul!
2. 1.
Gaelic.
2 versus...
On
good
my
five.
Stay Irish! The Irish blood!
Holy
the sick cats across!
Yes.
Now, Douglas, having to take 5 physical damage, I do
5.
Believe...
You have to go to church every night as a boy, that's what I did.
Stop talking!
You take 3, you take 3.
2. He hits like a bison.
3.
And we have our first death!
Thank God!
It's not me!
Oh, no, not the first death. Oh no, that's what your hair looked like underneath that hat.
I want to see if he dies and he makes that face.
He will.
His lips are still up like that.
Yeah, they're
now we have a bit of an event that only Douglas gets to know about.
Okay.
So when you die, you get to reveal your card, whether or not you were a witch. Was Douglas the witch?
I was not a witch.
Could have fooled me.
As the first character who died, you get to read this secretly. Let me know what stickers you need.
You're dead. Here's a sticker.
It's basically the doctor.
All right, so we now have a new rule in the rulebook called placing ghosts. And I will place them here. Basically, every time a player dies, you place a ghost sticker in an empty spot on that tile. If all the spots on that tile are already filled, do nothing. No vacancy in this hotel. If you run out of stickers and need to place one, you do nothing. And we have a ghost sticker, so we'll always remember that right by the pond, Douglas got his shit rocked.
Okay, well, there were two rounds.
He
at
did
least.
Get his shit rocked so slow.
I said I was lanky.
All right, Beatrix.
Belinda.
Sure.
I will say, all of us have been attacking. There's a death. We have got confirmation that that death was not the witch. We could also avoid each other. There's no guarantee we would go insane every turn. We roll a die for it, so we could have no insanity. Just saying.
Well, I'm feeling like I want to also fight the Irishman.
Fight me, but also kiss me. Yeah! Please,
don't touch me. Here we go. Ooh,
we've got to kill the Irish.
If my speed is 4, can I even get over to you?
1, 2, 3, 4. Yes, you can.
Okay, here we go, motherfucker.
I'll never die, just like the movie The Irishman and how long it was.
2.
4 dice versus 4 dice, yet again.
All right.
Are you sure you don't want to come over after this?
I can't explain it enough. I hate your guts and I don't even know you.
My mom knows where your son is. Okay, here we go.
What? Wait, what?
You know
where I'm gonna live. 1, 2, 3. Come on!
F***ing
3 versus... Are you rolling?
The Irish!
I take 4 physical damage.
Gaelic football was what I did back in the day when I was a boy.
And that's just pure murder.
And that was pure might.
4 physical damage.
Okay, 4 physical damage, which means it's either speed or might.
And you can split it.
Oh,
I can
God.
Barely fit my pants on because my thighs.
2 feral hogs in those pants.
Hey! My thighs wrap around a woman like you wouldn't believe.
Ew.
Listen, you Irish piece of shit, I'm still alive and you're gonna tell me where Ronald is?
My mom knows where Ronald is, but if you come over, spaghetti and sandwiches, I'd tell you everything you
now
want
to know.
Now
it's a sandwich. Oh, God. Here we go.
Anything you want.
All right. This is madness. I do not wish to partake in all this violence right now, and I'm the one with a gun. So I do have the chalice of insanity. So I'm going to go 1, 2, 3, 4 and get away from this, and I'm going to sip from the chalice of insanity. I lose 1 sanity after doing this, but I get to roll 5 dice and see what happens.
Oh, you get to drink it?
I get to drink it. Is it gonna be delicious? It is higher than a 4, so that means I gain 1 might, 1 speed, and 1 knowledge.
Oh, what a drink that was.
I feel like I've learned so much. It's better than college, I tell you that much right now. I did do the thing and I didn't attack you, so I do take the risk of losing some sanity. Let's see if I lose any sanity by the end of this. Okay, only 1, so I'm down to 1 sanity, so I will have to start attacking soon.
I've just been sitting here looking at the sun. Oh, what's that?
Yeah.
Another fight?
You still have enough speed to get over.
I've got enough speed, and I still got
whiskey
in Glasgow.
Go, Cornelius.
And we're gonna go, Irishman.
Dublin and Dublin.
Go, Cornelius, go.
All right, so let me get my dice.
You got 4.
And what do you have, 2?
2.
I'll cap him. I'll cap
Good
him like
luck.
I'm gonna cap Cornelius's balls.
3! No! So
with,
close!
With a difference of 1, you have to lose a physical trait, which means...
An 8!
No.
Goodbye!
Don't leave me here alone with this creep!
Good sport, good guy. Can we get him out of here? I don't want to smell it.
You are very stinky. Can you reveal whether or not you were the witch? Please.
Stinky.
Of course I was not a witch.
I knew it.
Oh my God.
You've killed 2 men.
You've killed 2 people.
You think me,
I'm
the
just
quiet
Irish.
Woman in the corner, is the witch?
You're not quiet. Your voice haunts my soul at night. Nate, so I'm gonna fight.
All right, let's fight.
Are you sure about this? It's not gonna end well for you.
I also wanna say real quick, I completely did the Chalice of Insanity wrong, but we're gonna roll with it and we'll just deal with the 2 comments.
I'm at 4 might.
I have 4 might.
You do?
Here we go.
Yo, Brian started a
I really want you to
Gaelic, Gaelic, Gaelic.
This is for Cornelius and the prune guy. Come on. No,
two
no,
versus
no.
five.
Three.
You just three.
Samantha.
That's what an Irishman does. He eats corned beef and cabbage and he frits and kills women.
Well, I hope you're happy.
I'm really sad,
I hope you're happy now.
I'm really sad, actually. I really liked you. I really liked you.
Is that how you treat people you like?
Yes, that's all I know. You kill them.
Were you the witch?
No.
You were not... You were not the witch.
Tell Ronald I love him!
I don't know where he is, but my mom does.
You! I have given you the benefit of the doubt this whole time. Never once attacking you. But my sanity is at its bare minimum, and now I must. Unless I want to go insane, which I haven't! Even though I drank from the chalice of insanity!
I've been drinking this whole game.
Yeah,
and I'm fine!
You smell like a brewery.
Really? Well, he smells dead!
One, two,
you're a
three.
Murderer. No, I'm not.
I will now.
I'm a good man. You're
well, we'll see, because I have four might and a gun! So...
Oh, I don't care about
target
that.
Anyone on your tile or an adjacent tile on your region. Roll one additional die on your attack. Actually, I would have to make you come to me. I can roll a might roll from over here, but it says speed. So the attack is based off speed, so I get to roll six dice on my attack.
Well, what do I get to roll?
Nothing, because you are getting shot at with a gun, and you, I know the reach of an Irishman.
Bullets don't hit me that, ever. They just swoop right by me. Do you know that Titanic was made in Dublin?
One, two, three, four, five, six. I'm doing six points. Right. Of damage, I'm doing 6 points of damage at you potentially. Now you know what? You roll these four die. They're bad luck. There you go.
You don't know me. Everyone says the O'Briens are bad luck, but we survive.
Shut up.
You're dead.
Thank you.
You're dead. And my mother's knife.
Two. So I do four physical points of damage at you. Take it from your speed or your might.
I'll divvy it
up.
If
you hit a skull, you die.
I'll take down my speed because people keep coming to me. One, two. Are you happy?
I am.
My family is alive, most of them. It's pretty good.
It's your turn. It's between us. One of us is a witch.
Wait, what? Right, so I go right
yes,
now.
Yes, you can either run away and potentially lose sanity, or you can attack me. The learned man, the most learned man in
O'Briens
the village.
O'Briens don't run. They walk.
Oh God.
Towards their fate.
So you get to you get to roll with three, I get to roll with four. Because your might is now three.
Right.
All right. Ready, roll at the same time. Right. Really roll them.
Right.
Three.
Gaelic.
Two.
Gaelic.
He really likes you.
Gaelic.
One, two, three, four, five. One, two, three. So you take 2 points of physical damage.
What?
Yes.
You're a witch. That's what this is.
No.
Witchcraft.
I'm a learned man. I'm a learned man.
You're a banshee.
I'm a learned man. A banshee, I'd go, ah!
You just did it!
Take 2 points of physical damage.
Where?
From either speed or might.
O'Briens never die. We walk to our fates, and we live forever.
Now listen, I'm not a witch, and you say you're not a witch, so let's go about this like civilized adults.
But you're a witch.
Let's go about this like civilized adults. We could run away from each other and let our sanity tick away.
Never.
Okay, then I'm going to use my gun and shoot you.
But, wait,
so
yes,
I'm going to roll my six dice.
But.
I'm going to roll my six dice.
But.
It could blow up in his face.
But.
Oh.
So that's going to be an eight, a nine. Go ahead and roll your three dice, which are statistically impossible.
So I'm going to beat you. That's what's going to happen right here.
Yes. Wow.
We're about to witness something impossible.
I'm a learned man who had a gun.
Gaelic. Gaelic. Mother's corned beef.
Ha!
Wow.
Wow.
Wow, a six.
Two, four, six.
So you still take 3 points of damage.
And you still die.
What?
You still die.
But I've got tons of knowledge. Can't I take it
off
of that?
Nope,
not. You can.
Now we also add a ghost to the front steps tile.
Ow! It shot me right here in my heart.
Rory, would you like to reveal your card as to whether or not you were the witch?
Yeah, I'll reveal my card. Because I'm still alive right now. The bullet's just taking its time. My card is a normal human kindness.
Now I will reveal something that maybe only Chance knew. Chance, actually, would you like to reveal this specific bit of knowledge?
Douglas. Prune boy?
There is no way.
Page 117 in the journal. This place is mine now, it seems. So there was no witch after all. Strange how we all believed there was. Ah, well, no matter. The fields have been fertilized. I have disposed of the bodies. Home is where the hearts are. Let us hope the dead stay buried. Each player should record their character's fate on the back of their family card. Remember, this is for flavor only. Have fun with it. So, death by Irishman for most of you, shot in the face by a purple wizard. As you're doing this, a little bit more journaling. I was not accustomed to so much digging and grew weary near the end. I hope the bodies are buried deep enough. And thus concludes the first episode of Bored AF Legacy. Betrayal at Haunton. On the house of the, there's a big old spooky house. I'm not doing it again. Hey, come join us next week to see what happens, what is it, 18 years in the future? Where Charlemagne is still, oh, it's 28 years in the future. Ooh. Charlemagne is still alive and much older, and maybe their descendants, maybe their friends, long lost relatives will come to this house for their very own reason. Can it get even more Irish than it did before?
Yes, it can. Someone's coming, and you're all gonna be a scarred. My family is
This man's family is strong.
And fertile.
Very fertile. If anyone would just let us touch them. Anybody.
Do not breed with that family.
If you want to see more Bored AF and things we've done in the past, check out over here or check out over here. But don't worry, we've got more Bored AF Legacy coming right at you. Oh. Let us know if you had fun, because I had fun. You guys did a great job.
Thank you, but I'm still smelling the stench of your body.
We're both in hell now.
That's so
fighting for eternity.